Not like the first Quickie. What if you want to say that your own cockamamie idea, like creationism or the flat earth, is right, and all of these scientists are wrong? Well, in addition to all the other things you need to do, such as make your theory falsifiable, you need to conform to the correspondence principle. Basically, the correspondence principle says that your new theory must explain why the old theory it's supplanting worked as well as it did, as far as it did. When Einstein's relativity supplanted Newtonian mechanics, Einstein did so, in part, by explaining why Newton worked as well as it did. In fact, if you take Einstein's equations and resolve them in an inertial reference frame, everything else cancels out, except for the equations as Newton gave them. As long as your speed isn't a significant portion of the speed of light, and your gravitational field isn't that big, Newton still works pretty well. Newtonian physics got the astronauts to the moon, after all. But it doesn't work for everything. GPS satellites need to be adjusted for relativistic effects because of the high degree of precision required to make the system work. Niels Bohr actually dubbed the term when explaining why quantum mechanics was a better theory than Einsteinian relativity. He showed that, as bewilderingly different as quantum mechanics is on the level of subatomic particles being fundamentally probabilistic, as it makes larger systems of atoms and molecules, these probabilities converge on either 0 or 100%, and the universe appears deterministic. You have to show why the old theory worked as well as it did. And that's what you'll never get out of creationists or flat earthers or any other woo, because they work by denying that the existing theory works at all, and that it's only accepted because there's this secret scientific cabal that's controlling all the journalists and the textbooks. Really, it's just about making them seem like the smart one. Well, sorry, sunshine, but it don't work that way. You can only show that your theory is better if you can explain why the old one is as good as it is. Otherwise, you're just trying to give cover to feeble-minded nonsense.